Oh my goodness, hello everyone. It is me, Cookie Baker. I have taken over the Feather Place's Instagram, and I'm reporting to you guys live right now from New Orleans, Louisiana. We are fixing to have a whole lot of fun, y'all. I'm just gonna wait for a few people to tune in, because you know what? I said I was going live at 7, and let me tell you, I am a punctual queen. Not very many drag queens arrive on time. Not only was I on time, but I've been sitting here for the longest 10 minutes of my life. So now it is officially 7 o'clock, so I'm going live. So anyway, I hope everyone is doing well out there and staying safe. Lord knows this is some crazy times. So you know, why not just kick back, have a cocktail, and do some crafting with a man in a dress, honey. You know, what is better than that? I mean, I can't think of anything more fun than crafting with a cocktail with a man in a dress, honey. Yes. I decided to just wear sensible jewelry today, nothing too flashy, you know. Don't wanna get obstructed and get attacked by a glue gun. But we're gonna get started, so, you know. Again, all of these products are available at the Feather Place. They have you can buy them from their website, which is The Feather Place. You can also get them on Etsy, which, let me look at my cheat sheet. Don't tell anyone. So it's Zucker Feather Place on Etsy. So you can also find their products there. But first, we're gonna get started. First things first, honey, I'm the realist. So we're gonna make a fun and fabulous cocktail. Look at this little boa. You can also get this at the Feather Place. I love it. A little headband for your nerves, also available at the Feather Place. So I'm gonna set this boa down because I don't wanna mess it up. Now we're gonna make a little cocktail. I'm also gonna show you guys how to make this wonderful little adornment for your glassware. It's also helps so you know, so everyone can have a different one because you don't wanna be drinking after someone because you don't know what kind of diseases they have, especially in this pandemic, honey. So get yourself a fun and festive glass. Oh, it's so heavy. We're gonna make a little bourbon drink because mama loves the brown liquor. So this is gonna be super easy. Let me go ahead and put this down so you guys can see what's going on. So this is a super, super easy cocktail. And it also helps to open up your airways because you know, you gotta be able to breathe, honey. So you just get you a fun little glass like this. Get you some crushed ice. I'm gonna put a lot of ice because it's gonna be so hot with all these lights. So you know, just a little ice. Now this is super simple to make. This is a honey and ginger infused simple syrup. So all you do is you take a cup of sugar, a cup of water, and just like a handful of sliced ginger, and you simmer it for 15 minutes. Then you strain it. Once it's cooled, you add a little honey, and there you go. Voila, a little simple syrup infused with ginger and honey. And a little lime, you're gonna need that. And you're gonna need some whiskey or bourbon, whatever you prefer, no judgment here. You can put as little or as much as you'd like. Again, no judgment, I'm not here to judge actions, only outfits, honey. And if you're wearing fun things from the Feather Place, I will never judge you. So just put a little bit of whiskey, just a little bit, not too much. I'm grown. And then you take your ginger infused honey syrup, put that in there, so good. And then you just take a little lemon, give it a little squish. And then I went out to the garden and picked a little fresh rosemary, which is fun because it can be used as a swizzle stick and it'll give you a little flavor. And you just stir it up, you know, and voila, you have your little quarantini, is what I'm calling it. And I'm gonna use a reusable metal straw because I care about the turtles. So yeah, so I hope you guys have your cocktails ready. Lord knows I do. Let's have a little sip. Put a lot of whiskey in it, because I'm grown. that is delightful because you got the heat from the ginger and a little bit of honey and lemon to soothe the throat. It's just what you need. Mm-mm-mm. So yeah. So now that we all have been cocktailed, I'll just show you guys some fun little easy crafts. So I guess we'll get started with this. So how fun is this? It's very festive. You can use whatever feathers you want, but I'll show you guys how simple this is to make. So to start, this is the only part that's semi-technical, but it's really not. So you just get you a piece of elastic and you get you whatever glass you're gonna be covering. Here's the secret. You wanna cut the elastic a little bit shorter than the glass that you're gonna put it on. See what I'm saying? You gotta have some tension. And I was really feeling the fantasy today, so I just bust out my needle and I just whip stitched it real quick together. It's not that difficult to do. Or if you don't wanna do that, just hot glue it. I don't care. No judgments here. So you see, it just fits on the glass. So this is super, super simple. So all you gotta do is get the feathers of your choice. I got these. These are, I think, guinea plumes. And they're really fun, because look, they're like polka dotted. And these are natural, they're not dyed, and I would stick to natural feathers because when you drink, your glass will get condensation on it, and if it's a dyed feather, the colors could run. So I would just stick to natural feathers. It's just fun. So yeah. So all you gotta do is just get you some feathers, which is real fun when you're wearing nails. We'll see how this goes. I'm probably gonna take the flowers and rip these nails off in a minute. But yeah, you just dump them out. And you just get to crafting. That's gonna be a problem because now my fingers are wet from my cocktail, but I will persevere. So you just find these fun little feathers. And you know, sometimes you have some like this that's they're a little wonky, but that's fine. No one's perfect, not even me. So just cut it. Now this is where it gets really, really tricky. So very carefully, you take your hot glue gun, you put a little dab of glue on it. And I like to go where the seam is. So you see the seam is right here. So you just go ahead and start. I like to start kind of in the middle. And you just glue it down. Revolutionary. I like to cut the bottoms off. I like to use just the tip. It's a game us dry queens like to play. Just the tip. And you just keep putting them all around until it's all nice and covered. And I just like the colorful little spotty tips. So, you know, you just cut them. You can cut a few at a time, whatever you want. Doesn't matter, it's crafting. And it's not reinventing the wheel, it's not rocket science. At the end of the day, you're just making beautiful things with beautiful things, with beautiful people. So you see, you just glue it. See, and if you have fake nails, it's perfect because you can just use the nail to affix it with the hot glue. You see what I'm saying? So you don't burn yourself. See, and at this point, you can use whatever feather you want. This green one wants to be used. She's really working my nerves. But you know, you just take the feathers, put a little glue. And you just want to make some kind of pattern. Just a little circle. Nothing crazy. It's not that serious. And these would be great if you're having people over, or you can send these as a gift. You know, how fun would that be for your friend that's, you know, locked up in her house going crazy? How fun would that be if you just sent her a little set of these fun little glass huggers, you know, so she could be all fancy by herself. And then maybe you can call her when she gets it. If she's a good friend, she'll call you when she receives the package. But yeah, see guys, it's just that easy. You just put a little dab of glue, press it down, you know, it is what it is. Just let the feathers do what they want to do. Don't try and make them do crazy things. Just let it be a feather. Just let it fall. And there you go. Isn't this the cutest little hot glue gun? It's so cute. And it's got a little tip, so that way you can be real precise with your glue. So you see, look how fun that is. Look. Now, you could just leave it like that if you're basic. But you know what? We're gonna bling it up. So, I just so happen to be a purveyor of fine gay bric-a-brac of all sorts of wonderments. All of these luxurious glass crystals, which you can find at shop.misscookiebaker.com. So you can just get you some cute little crystals. Look at that. Oh my gosh. And very simple. You just take your glass. You see where all the feathers meet? You just put a little dab of glue. Be very careful not to touch the glue. And wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. Look at that. I mean, this looks like I would have spent hundreds of dollars to buy this in a shop. But look, you can make it yourself using wonderful products from Zucker Feathers. I mean, look, I didn't even use not even a quarter of this bag. And I made two of them. I mean, look at this. You know, and if you want to add more rhinestones, you can. But I think one is cute. And the beauty of it is, when you're done, it stores flat. So if you want to send this to a friend, honey, you put that in an envelope, and away she goes. And just like that, you could have your very own little glass dress. Ain't that cute? That's too much. But wait, there's more. Let me tidy this up real quick. But yeah, you know, hopefully you guys have been crafting. If you guys have kids, they can do this. Because you know what? You can make that into a bracelet. Stop it right now. If you have a really big arm. But see? OMG, look at that. If you cut it a little smaller, oh my God. It's too much. I can't. But I did, and there's plenty more. So let me move this out the way. And let's move on to the next project, because there's so many more projects. So yeah, it's gonna take me longer to clean up than it did to actually make that project. Can you freaking believe it? Oh my God. Now, I don't know about you guys, but during these trying times, bitch gotta get economical. You know what I'm saying? You can't be splurging on expensive bottles of wine. You can't afford it, you know? Baller on a budget, honey. So you know what? I have found a new love for box wine. Yeah, I said it. I drink box wine. I don't care, you can judge me. But I like box wine. I freaking love it. It's cheap, it's in a box, but it's tacky as hell. You know what I'm saying? So, y'all, not even gonna believe this. OMG, look at this. I mean, honey, this is class with a capital K and three S's, honey. This is so classy. And you can make this for such a small amount of money. With the amount of money you save buying box wine, you can dress that box up, honey. Look at this. They'll never even know. They'll think it's like Cristal or something because they'll be mesmerized. And y'all, I'm gonna show y'all how simple this is to make. I'm not gonna make one because I'll show you how I made this and you guys are not even gonna believe it. You're gonna be like, no way. So, look at this. It's freaking taped. Look, Zucker Feather sells these dyed Coke Feather trim. So all you have to do, it takes two packs. All you do is just very easily, you unroll it from the pack and you just gently roll, starting from the top, and you just cover the box If you want to use hot glue, you can, but I'm going to reuse these feathers for something else, for the next box. So honey, all you have to do is just wrap it around and use a little clear packing tape and just tape it in place. Your friends will never even know that for 2 yards of over-dyed coke feathers, you can dress up your own box of wine. And then I just made a little patch here with 3 peacock eyes and some more of those wonderful jewels from shop.misscookiebaker.com, honey. And the best part is, when I'm done with this box of wine, I just gently glued it in place. When I'm done, I can take this off very easily. Boom. Now I got a headpiece. You know, honey, you put this on a little alligator clip like this, look. Watch. Watch me. All you have to do is just get one of these little clips like this. You can then glue this to said clip and freaking clip it. I mean, that's a 2-for-1 right there. That's a 2-for-1. Y'all taking notes? Y'all better be taking notes. Got some more for you. So you know, I'm here in the South. You go to all these summer weddings, it's hot as hell. And again, sometimes I can be classy. Sometimes I can be a little trashy, honey. I am not afraid to let my Miller Lite shine, honey. This little Miller Lite of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. So you go to these weddings, and what do they give you? They give you these koozies like this, you know? It's little, you know, insulated can things. Well, you know, 9 out of 10, the wedding ends in divorce before the first year. So you can't be using these koozies from your friend's wedding that is no longer in existence. The marriage is over, honey. So what are you gonna do with it? You're not gonna waste it. You're gonna repurpose it with feathers from the feather place. Look at this. Look how friggin' fancy that shit is. Look at this. I mean, honey, you could drink White Claw if you're basic, Miller Lite if you're classy, or whatever you want, honey. You can pop a Diet Coke in here. But look at this. Store's flat. You can send it to a friend. Honey, if you have a party and you have all these fun little koozies, you'll be the talk of the town, honey. You'll be living large and in charge in that double wide, honey. Yes! I'm gonna show you how to make it. So all you need is a koozie that you're gonna repurpose. This is from a restaurant here. You know, it's cute, but I'll make it better. So, again, very inexpensive and totally economical. Look at these. It's just a box, a little bag of green feathers. Watch how easy this is. So when you get these feathers, you know they're cute, they all right. But you know, sometimes they're a little crazy, they do crazy things, they don't look right. You could fix that. Just take your handy dandy scissor and you trim. So you just take it and you just cut it at an angle. Just go to the tip, honey, and just snip it. Turn it around, go to the other side, give it a little snip snip. Sometimes you miss one, but look. And then sometimes you have all these, just get rid of it. Just cut it down, cut it down, cut it down. Flip it over, give it a little trim, trim, trim. How much more fun is that? And then also, save yourself some trouble for later, just cut this little piece off. But you see, now you have a cute little feather. And like, sometimes, you know, you get them and they're like all wonky like this. It's fine, just gently brush it back. See right here? It's a little wonky. Get that scissor out. Trim it even, honey. Just like cutting bangs. I don't recommend cutting your own bangs. That's gonna end horribly. So yeah, just trim all the little feathers like this. And now it looks like a little leaf. It's cuter, it's tighter, it's more compact. Then you check your little koozie. If your koozie has like a lot of writing on it, don't worry, we're gonna fix it. Watch this. So you can get, this is another kind of feather. This is just like a big fluffy feather. I'm gonna trim this down. So I'm just gonna cover the base real quick. So just put a little glue on it. And we're basically just going to build a little foundation. So we'll just take some of these green ones. And we're just gonna cover, you know, if there's any writing, like, you know, congratulations on your wedding, Billy Sue and Billy Joe. It was nice while it lasted, but that ship has sailed, honey. So just cover up, you know, any harsh decorations on it. See, so now you kind of have it covered. So now you have a base. So now that that's done, see, I just cut all different ones, shapes and sizes. This is where it gets tricky, y'all. It's very technical. Especially if you have freaking fake nails on. Real fun. So yeah, so now that you have your base, you take your feathers. Start at the bottom here, and we're just gonna put one here, one here, one here, one here, and one in the middle. See, we're just making a little pattern, you see? So it only takes, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So all you need is 7 feathers. So, you know, sometimes the feather will have a little curve to it. So use that to your advantage. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this one over here because it curves out. I think that's gonna be fun. It's gonna give it some shape. So we're just gonna put a little bit, find the center. And you just press it down. Revolutionary. I know. And then get another one. Put a little glue. And when you're gluing feathers, put it on the center part. Put that glue on that hard center part. And it'll just be perfect for you, you see? Just glue it down. That's one row. So now we're gonna go with the second row. This one's really freaking cute. So now you do another one. And we're just sort of trying to make like a little leaf pattern. It's gonna kind of look like a maple leaf, you see? And then you take another one. Put a little glue on the vein. I think that's what it's called. And then you just pop her down. Look at that. Amazing. And then you take another one. And you pop her on the other side. And then another one again. You glue it to your finger. You just keep going. And then you take one. The last one, and you just flop her right there in the middle. Would you look at that? Look at this. OMG, it's too much. Some would say that's enough. I would say never. So you can embellish it. If you have broken jewelry, use the broken jewelry, but look. I have this beautiful little rhinestone. Look at that. Oh my gosh. It's freaking beautiful. So I'm just gonna take this, put a little hot glue on it. Squish it right down in the middle. Wow. But there's more, because I also have these. Look at that. That's fancy. Oh, that looks like $1 million. So we're just gonna put one like that on each side. Got so many spider webs of hot glue, but it's okay. Gonna glue that right there. Y'all look at this. Voila. And that's just one side. If you wanna do the other side, by all means, knock your socks off. You know, but look, just like that, you have a totally new, fantastic little can hugger. See, this one I put a peacock eye. This one I didn't. It's up to you, whatever you want. You can make them all different. You can use different color feathers, rhinestones, you know, whatever you want. Look at that. Fancy. Revolutionary. I know. I'm gonna clean my fingers. You guys taking notes? I mean, we're moving fast. We did 25 minutes and we've already done 3 projects. 4 if you count one that was a 2-for-1. And made a cocktail. And halfway drank a cocktail. But yeah, you know, and the Feather Place also has wonderful little crafts, like little craft sets already made. So you can just get an assortment of all sorts of feathers and then just use those to make all sorts of wonderments, which is beautiful. Which brings us to our next craft. Y'all look at this. Stop it. Look at this. Honey, no one will accidentally pick up your wine glass if it looks like this, okay? Don't need to worry about drinking anyone else's backwash or anyone else's coronavirus. Honey, no ma'am. This is my glass, obviously. Look at that. Wow, can you believe it? I'm gonna show you guys how to make this. Super, super easy. Again, if you get the crafting kits, they're $30. They have a natural feather one, they have a peacock one, and then they have like a jewel tone one, which is like all of these fun, fabulous colors. I'm gonna show you how to make this. Very easy. And again, you could also use this in your hair. Honey, you can put a little pocket square and shove that in there. If you have a hat, you can put that on a hat. Whole new meaning to the term Yankee Doodle Dandy, honey. Yes. So look at this. This just looks like a bunch of garbage, but it's not. Watch this. Hold on. Let me clean up my fingers and I'm gonna show you guys a little trick. Sometimes you get some ostrich plumes that are beautiful. Sometimes you get some that are a little janky. Sometimes, you know, you light a cigarette a little too close to it, catches on fire, half of it burns up. Don't throw it away. You save it. Because you see all of this? You can use that to make these. Look at this. Very simple. These could be earrings. Look, you put a little rhinestone on it. Put it on an earring back. Wow. Honey, one of a kind. No one else will have it. So yeah, so if you have some feathers that are just like not perfect, very, very easy. I'll show you what to do. So this one, let me show you a few things. So this is just like a really thin gauge craft wire. It's real thin. I don't know if you guys can see it. Look, I'm gonna do like they do on Instagram. Like, oh, revolutionary. I know. So get you your pliers and just cut you a little piece. Those pliers are no good. I just use a scissor. It's fine. So get you a little piece of wire and then I like to take it and whip it like this and make like a little loop like this, you see? So just like double it, run it through itself and make like a little loop, you see? Like that. Then you can take these feathers, that's not so cute, but don't throw it away. Them plumes is high, that's real expensive. So if you just take a little piece like this, separate it, grab you a little chunk, go with this much, and just pull it off. See? You got you a nice little handful of this, look at that. So just kind of twist it, take your little loop like that. It's kind of fun with fingernails, but just kind of twist it. And then just shove it through that little loop you just made. Shove them all, get them all in there. And then fold it in on itself. And then just tighten that little loop that you made. And you're just gonna make a little lasso on those plumes. Sometimes if you have a pair of pliers, it makes it a little easier. Of course, today it's not gonna be that easy, but it will work. And then you just tighten it up. So see, now you have this little thing. And then what I like to do is take the wire and separate them and then wrap them around each other in opposite directions. So this one goes to the left, this one goes to the right, and you just wanna kinda wrap it up. Cause you're just making like a little tassel. And you know, if you don't have fingernails on, it's a little easier, but you know. So once you have it wrapped around a few times, then just go ahead and grab it again, pull them together, and give it a little twist. And now look at this. This little piece here, the little extra, just trim it off. Get rid of it. I have a trash can down here, so look. Now you have like a little, like a fancy fly fishing lure. See what I'm saying? And catch drag queens with these. We love feathers. Pause due to poor connection. Internet here is terrible. But yeah, so now you have this. So you can make them, you know, you can use as many feather scraps as you want. So now we're gonna make a super fun. Now that we made this little guy, now I'm gonna show you how to make the rest. So you can buy the dyed coke feather trim. They already like sew them onto a ribbon, so it makes it real easy. So use this as your base. So now that you have that, then you can just take all these fun different sizes and color feathers. See, this one got a little curve in it. I'm gonna show you how to do that. You can take your scissor and just run it along, and you can give her a little curl. Now she's got some fun. Now she's a fun girl. She's ready to party. And then you just grab a handful of all different size feathers, put them together, different colors, different textures, and you just kind of grip them together. It doesn't matter. Just let them do what they want. The more crazy they are, the better. You can always adjust them, but you know, you can spend days trying to make them all perfect. It's not even worth it. It's gonna be cute when you're finished. So take your little piece like this with the ribbon. Just go ahead and put a little line of glue in it. Grab your little handful of feathers, shove them right in there, and roll it up like a burrito. Look at that. Revolutionary. And then let that glue dry, just kind of hold it together. I didn't put this one in because I want it to be on the top. Because she's real cute. And the same thing, this is just a peacock sword that I ran the scissor to curl it. Just a quick little. And now she got a little curl. I think that's fun and festive. So now I'm gonna take that and I'm gonna glue that on the outside because I want that to kind of come up in the opposite direction just for no reason. Because I think that'll be cute. So just put a little glue there. Take this one. Set it right on top. Give it a little blow. Look how fun this is turning out to be. And then with all those little leftover random little ostrich plume trimmings that you save, just find one that speaks to you. See what looks good. I think that'll be fantastic. Look at that. Oh my God, that's so much fun. Let me just tidy up. I'm making a mess. So we're gonna take some more glue. But before we glue this on, we're gonna take, you can use floral wire, or I'm gonna use a pipe cleaner today. So I just take the pipe cleaner, pull it around, give it a twist, get all that stuff off of your nails. So leave a, maybe like, just leave a little space so that way it's has something to hold on to, because we're gonna cover that in a minute. And just give it a little twist so you have a little extra. And then put a little glue to hold that in place. So we're just gonna go ahead and glue this. And while we're gluing that, just put a whole lot of glue. We're not driving. And then once it's glued, take your little fluff, your little feather duster that you made, and just flop that right on in there. Look at that. That's freaking cute. Gosh, that's cute. It's also very hot too. Wowzers. But yeah, look at that. Ain't that fun? OMG, that's the cutest thing I've ever seen. So now that this is done, you see you got this little spot right here that's not too cute? Not a problem. Just get some broken jewelry, broken earring. I'm gonna use this little AB crystal. And I'm gonna glue that right over there. Right on the tip, honey. Just the tip. Trend. So we're gonna put a little glue on that. See, ugly spot. Put that little glue. Put that little stone. Give it a gentle blow. Have a little cocktail, because, you know, you've done so much, you deserve it. Now, you see, you could leave it like that if you want. Just one. I'm not fixing to do that. We're going to add more. Because more is always more. It's better. It's more better. So, yeah. So, you just take that, and you see, you just kind of flatten the feathers down. And we're gonna see what kind of little wonderments we have here. So we got just, oh, look at that. They're spilling everywhere. So I'm gonna use this, you know what, this one stuck to it. I feel like this one wants to be used, but that one's not that great. So I'm gonna take this little guy. Why not? I have it. You think? I think so. Look, we're just gonna put that right there. That's the beauty of this. You can just, you know, sometimes the feathers speak to you. And that one spoke to me and he said he wanted to be part of the party. So we're gonna glue him in right here. Cause I think that's fun. And he can't be by himself, he needs a friend. So we're gonna take this one. We're gonna trim it. Give her a fluff. Glue that on the side of her. Little friend. Add a little more glue there. Add that one. Press it down. Y'all look at this. This is too much. And then now we'll take another little AB crystal teardrop, honey. Ooh. No crying here. There is no crying and crafting, honey. There is no crying and crafting. Put a little glue on there. And we're just gonna flop that right at the top. Yo, that's freaking cute. That's too much. That's totes adorbs. But we're gonna add a little more. We're gonna add some more stones. So we're gonna go ahead and put one on each side of that little teardrop, because you know what? More is always more. So I'm gonna grab another little one very carefully. Put that right there. Grab another one. Y'all look at this. That is too much. And then once it's done, see, that's why you use a little pipe cleaner. Get your glass. It could be any kind of glass with a stem, honey. Any kind of glass. You just grab it and you just gently twist it in the back. Look at that. Look. You just pull it to the back and you give it a little twist. Then you take those extra pieces and you push it to the front. Y'all, look at that. Honey, if that doesn't say rich, I don't know what does. Y'all, do you look at that? And then the best part is, it's on a pipe cleaner, so when you're done, you can just untwist it, wash it, and save it for another party. Y'all, look at this. Dun, 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 dun. Can you believe it? Look at this. Did the video go out? Oh no. Can you guys see me? Oh no, the feed is gone? Sabotage. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this little crafting. I hope now you know you can make all of these wonderful things from the Feather Place. You can also find them at, you can find them on Etsy as well. And their Etsy shop is Zucker Feather Place. So if you're an Etsy person, if you're drinking that Etsy cult Kool-Aid, I love it, but Etsy is like a cult, honey, it's addicting. You can find their wonderful products at Zucker Feather Place on Etsy or thefeatherplace.com. I hope you guys had fun. I know I did. And look, in this short time, I showed you guys how to make fancy little wine glass decorations, how to make a fantastical koozie, little can hugger. Look at that. Oh my God. Y'all, I'm so extra that look, even the can matches the koozie. I am that psycho. Yes. It's got to match. Ridiculous. And then, you know, you could also make these. And, you know, you could do the same design that you did on this. You can do that on the little elastic band. But you see, I feel like this one could actually be a little bracelet. It's more suited to my delicate wrist. Okay, that's really cute, and it matches. I mean, that's super fun. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Stay tuned to The Feather Place here on Instagram. They have many more Instagram lives coming up. They have lots more people doing lots more wonderful things. I'm sure I will be back showing you guys more super fun things that you can make with feathers. Who does not love feathers? I love this. I love all of this. I am gonna take this off and I'm gonna put it in a hat and wear it because I can, because I love hats and I love all this fun stuff. And I think this is so extra and so ridiculous. I feel like everyone should drink out of glasses that have this much fine gay bric-a-brac on them. I mean, look at this. So anyway, you guys stay safe out there. Happy crafting. If your kids are driving you crazy, honey, get them a crafting kit from The Feather Place. They are $30. It is a huge bag. The bag is like this big, and it is full of wonderments. All of these fun feathers. There's just like all sorts of things. Your kids can get creative. Sometimes, you know, people just need an outlet. So give them something to do. You'll thank yourself. Honey, $30. Get a little crafting kit from The Feather Place. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. You guys stay safe. And remember, it's just crafting. It's not that serious, okay? Just let loose, honey. Sometimes you gotta get dressed up, put a little headband on, put a little lipstick, you know, throw on a feather boa, honey. just to go take out the trash. You know, just do something for you. And thank you guys so much. You guys have a good one. If I can figure out how to shut this live feed off, because I'm not real familiar with it. I'm new at this. Oh my gosh. Thank you guys so much.